Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah. Dear brothers and sisters, may Allah accept your siyam and qiyam. When the philosopher Kant, Immanuel Kant, when he was asked about enlightenment, he answered in an essay titled Sapere Aude, which is Latin for they dared to know, they dared to think, they dared to be wise. They emerged from self-imposed immaturity, laziness, cowardice, and blind obedience. 1,000 years prior to that, God sent the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, described in the Quran, لِيُخْرِجَهُمْ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ, to take him out of darkness to enlightenment. He was described in the Quran, وَيَضَعُ عَنْهُمْ إِصْرَهُمْ وَالْأَغْلَالَ الَّتِي كَانَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ. He is here to unload their backs from heavy burden from the past, a package of superstition and nonsense and mythology, and to break the chains from their bodies, enslavement, to liberate the people from enslaving each other, and to break the mental chains which prevent their minds to be open to the world. And his weapon was the Quran, وَجَاهِدْهُمْ بِهِ جِهَادًا كَبِيرًا. And when you read the Quran, you find literally hundreds of ayahs, not tens, hundreds of ayahs addressing this mind which has been liberated or on the way to be liberated. And you find these terms, أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ, don't you have a brain? أَفَلَا تَنْظُرُونَ, can't you see? أَفَلَا يُبْصِرُونَ, can't you have a vision? Can't you comprehend? أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ, أَفَلَا يَتَذَكَّرُونَ, can't you remember? أَفَلَا يَفْقَهُونَ, don't you understand? أَفَلَا يَهْتَدُونَ, can't you be on the right path? أَلَا يَعْلَمُونَ, don't you know? أُولِي الْأَبْصَارِ, those who have vision, and أُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ, those who have brains. So the Quran is a message to the mind and the brain and to the reason and rationality. Of course, with its music and words, it tickles the emotion and the feelings. And the ultimate goal is wisdom. يُؤْتِي الْحِكْمَةَ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَمَنْ يُؤْتَى الْحِكْمَةَ فَقَدْ أُوْتِيَ خَيْرًا كَثِيرًا. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam did that with the Quran, where he was able to awaken the people to their senses and bring to their attention they cannot worship the past. They cannot worship the ancestry with their good and bad. They cannot have a herd's mentality and follow the crowd. They cannot be blind and walk behind anyone blindly. And you find literally tens of ayahs addressing this when he was talking to the non-believer. قَالُوا بَلْ نَتَّبِعُ مَا أَلْفَيْنَا عَلَيْهِ آبَاءَنَا. We are used to it. We follow our ancestors. أَوَلَوْ كَانَ آبَاؤُهُمْ لَا يَعْقِلُونَ شَيْئًا وَلَا يَهْتَدُونَ. Even if their parents and ancestors were wrong, and by this he was able to awaken the people of Mecca and bring them to their senses and bring them to think and dare to think and to have judgment and reasoning. And Islam did it by breaking those tyranny of the despotic rulers and centers of oppression. And he was able to nullify the job of the middlemen, who place themselves between God and yourself. And their job was obsolete, and that, of course, brought a lot of wrath of those people who became out of job. The middlemen, whoever the religion is, there is middlemen who try to be making business and money of being between you and God. And there is nobody between you and your Creator. You can't talk to him directly. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam did this by the scientific methodology, which we know it nowadays. He is the one who invented observation, invented the induction and deduction, and the inference. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam wanted, if you have a belief or a faith or a anything in this world, and you know it's true, he wants the justification. Prove it. And you find this word in the Quran coming so many times. وَمَنْ يَجْعَلْ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَٰهًا آخَرَ لَا بُرْهَانَ لَهُ بِهِ. You have no justification for worshiping whatever beside God, then it's false. And you find this word, burhan, justification, in many, many of the ayahs. And Islam and Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam prevented this moral dogmatism, which we saw it with communism, and they were right, and they believe they are right, and they did all this mayhem, killing over 60 million in the communist evil empire, and with their leaders who are those sure of their whatever methodology, and where are they now? All of them went down the drain. So he warned us of dogmatism, moral dogmatism, and moral certainty. Where is Hitler and all his certain ideas about his purity and so on of the faith and the blue-eyed big lie he made and killed over 60 million people? And the same thing, if you go to history and read, you find the Crusaders, they killed millions of Muslims and Jews because they're right, and they're with their dogma that they're doing something good. And nowadays we know it's one of the shameful pages in the history of mankind. And of course, he attacked the moral hypocrisy and the pride, which can create illusions, warned us of pride, which most of those people who have grandiose ideas and they are right and they are authenticated all these atrocities and they think they are right and they are not. We have to be very keen on this issue. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us to be careful. Our scholars taught us to be careful. You find great scholars like Imam Shafi'i, he tells you my opinion is right, but there is a chance to be wrong. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us in the Quran, وَمَا أَدْرِي مَا يُفْعَلُ بِي وَلَا بِكُمْ. And when he is asked, are you sure your deeds will enter you heaven? He said, no. إِلَّا أَن يَتَغَمَّدِنِيَ اللَّهُ بِرَحْمَتِهِ. It's up to God's mercy. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, when he was asked, are you better than a dog or a dog better than you? He told him, I don't know. It depends. If I end in heaven, I'm better than the dog. But if I end in otherwise, the dog is better than me because he become dust. وَيَقُولُ الْكَافِرُ يَا لَيْتَنِي كُنْتُ تُرَابًا. That means I wish to be an animal, so I will end up to be a dust. And all our scholars, you find they end their argument with the word Allahu A'lam. So they are not certain. God knows better. So there is a chance I might be wrong. And we have to adopt this attitude to be on the straight path and be safe from being drifted this way or that way. May Allah bless you all. Wassalamu alaikum.